try it again. I'm like, we gotta try it again. What happened? Nothing happened. You did a great job.
Thanks.
Lexi, you did really good.
I practiced
as good as you can do. You fucking kicked ass and sticks. You fucking held it down. Pretty fucking damn good. I thought we did 100%, 110% on that one. But I'm being totally fucking honest with you. I know that Nashville is pretty fucking spoiled. You guys got a lot of fucking accent and shit coming through town. And that audience response was fucking bullshit.
No, I agree. That was weak.
I'm not trying to be a dick. I'm not trying to, but I'm going to hold the mirror up to you right fucking now. Yeah, it's time to fucking put a little more effort into it, Nashville. We're going to end the song one more fucking time. And this time, everybody's going to make some fucking noise.
And I'm going to!
And your life is going to show its tits, all right? Let's do this shit.
Singer of Steel Fucking Panther, Mr. Michael Jackson!
going on, I was sharing the music that was getting played. It was like fucking 80s. How many people love 80s heavy metal? Yeah, I miss it too. I miss it. Like, I miss pussy every night, man. You know, if you fuck a hot girl, you just think about her next night, you think about fucking her again, and then somebody else walks up and you fuck her, and then you think about her next night, and then somebody else walks up and you fuck her. That's what heavy metal's all about. It's about fucking, dude. What's that? I mean, you need to get a gig. Bass player usually just blow the promoter, and that's why we're here tonight.
Yeah.
But I'm looking at the audience, and I see a lot of people have never seen this before. This is great, like you. I know you've never seen this before. Because you're looking at me like I'm fucking crazy right now. Because your husband probably dragged you here and said, oh, you're going to like this show. You got to come see the singer. He makes girls suck his dick. It's so cool. That's right, babe. You're just like Bill Cosby. Hey. Singer though.
Wow,
check this out. I had her all wrong. She brought me a scarf to wipe off all the sperm off her stomach. Thank you.
You don't have to worry, it's not gonna hit your face with our singer, it just dribbles out.
It's like oatmeal.
Hey, but I want you to know all my sperm comes out like oatmeal, but it's completely organic, so you're not gonna worry about it. And it's vegan free too.
I don't even know what that means.
That means it's fucking made of heavy metal meat, bro.
That's fucking awesome.
That's right. I want to introduce you, speaking of fucking meatheads, I want to introduce you to one of the guys, I mean, speaking of a guy with a big sack of meat between his legs. And I know the ladies in the VIP can't wait to suck it after the show.
Oh yeah. Hey, if you want to fucking practice on something, go to fucking Chipotle and try to fit one of those burritos all the way in your mouth, right?
Those burritos are huge.
Yeah, big burritos are a lot of shit.
Everybody on lead guitar, I want you to put your hands together for my good friend. Make some noise for Sancho!
This is fucking awesome. I want to fucking thank everybody who fucking came tonight, and I want to thank you fucking three dudes for taking a fucking step back from the barrier and letting some pussy up there. Yeah. You're all cute and shit, but if you're fucking looking for a blowjob, you better go to the bass player's. And you're wondering what it's like to suck on his balls, just put two raisins in a hefty bag and suck on my throat. It's the same feeling, and it's completely shaved, just like that. So, I know what a lot of people are thinking. If you just walked in the show, you've never seen fucking Steel Panther before, and fucking, you know, looking at the stage, you're probably thinking, what the fuck, dude? The fucking bass player is either the fucking prettiest fucking man I've ever fucking seen. The Farrah Fawcett rose from the grave and picked up the fucking bass guitar. Make some motherfucking noise for one of my favorite fucking bass players ever and one of the foxiest guys I've ever met in my fucking life. That fucking comes in handy. Fucking on tour for 5 or 6 weeks with Judas Priest, like we were just on. A lot of the girls are fucking so fucking old that their fucking tits fucking hit their fucking knees when they walk and shit. That fucking old fucking gray mustaches and shit. You just wait until he fucking falls asleep on the back of the tour bus, starts to snore with his mouth open, you fucking dip your dick right
just
in.
Just go ahead and introduce
me. Make some noise for Lexi.
Great to be back here. Thanks so much for showing up to see us for the second fucking time. It's badass. Awesome. I want to thank just a couple of them. You know who some of my influences are. Bitchin' looking motherfuckers. Like Rudy Sarzo from Whitesnake or Quiet Riot. He looked bitchin'. He was a good band. Badass bass player. Cinderella, Donkin, they were bitchin'. Whitesnake, Danger Danger. Cheryl Teagues. Elle McPherson. Christy Brinkley.
If you're not making noise right now, you're probably ugly.
Yeah. Okay. Lead singer for Slaughter, dude, that bitch is looking.
Oh, he was fucking hot back in the day.
He was good looking. Well, he was good looking. Doesn't make any difference. He was good looking. He was handsome. Had bitch in here. John Corabi. Well, he had his. I don't know about that. Please make some noise for the best fucking drummer in our band. We'll be right back.
fourth month in a row, being out in a row. First off, we went out with a little band called Judas Priest. Anybody remember that band? How many people saw us when we did the Judas Priest show?
That was not an easy tour for us, to say the least. There was an older crowd there. A lot of the ladies were pretty fucking old. There's pros and cons, obviously. The fucking pussies were pretty fucking dry, so you had to spit on that shit. But
sometimes I just take a full beer and pour it on a pussy and go to town.
Let's kick ass, because then you get the carbonation and the flavor as well.
What's cool for me is when sometimes, because they're so old, they have false teeth, that when they don't give hummers, they give gummers, because you can take those fucking things right out.
Exactly. Plus, you don't have to worry about squirming inside the vaginas because they've all been through menopause and shit like that.
So after that fucking long tour, we took a little jaunt over to Japan and knocked out about a fucking week tour over Japan. Fuck yeah.
Oh yeah, how many people went to Japan? Raise your hands! Those people probably don't even speak English.
Well, I'll tell you, we did some extensive Asian hooker research out there.
You know what I discovered?
What?
The Asian hookers love to cook in the another assholes.
Yeah, and then after Japan, went back to LA, had a party at the Rainbow, then hopped on a plane and went to London, did a fucking radio show and a tour out in London, hopped back, 5 days later, we're standing in front of you right fucking now, dude.
Exactly. I think that's pretty fucking impressive for a fucking dude like this dude right here, who just turned 65 years old a couple weeks ago. And let me tell you something, dude. After having two brand new titanium hip transplants, about 17 liposuction surgeries, 14 fucking facelifts, and he's still up here fucking singing like he's in his fucking late 50s, as far as I'm concerned.
You know why, dude? I do it because I love heavy metal more than I love anything in the fucking world, dude.
I know. There's nothing you wouldn't do for fucking heavy metal.
No, dude, I would have sex with my mom and my grandmother and shoot a load of sperm in my mom's face for fucking heavy metal.
That's pizza.
That's commitment.
What would you do?
Dude, there's nothing that I would do.
Tell them what you wouldn't do.
There's a long list. Nothing.
Just
that
give us
do.
One.
I would do everything for heavy metal.
You have to give. How many of you want to hear one thing you would do for heavy metal?
People are pretty much okay. All of this, I would fucking kill a baby seal with my bare hands for heavy fucking metal.
Wow, that's fucking.
You don't have bare hands, you have human hands.
Don't have to fucking reach out.
Lexi, what would you do for heavy metal?
Oh, I know what I would do. I would take a little baby, and I would go in a car, and we would go driving, and we go to a shopping mall where it's really hot, like in Nevada somewhere. And I would go shopping, and I would leave the baby in the car with the windows open.
Wow. It sounds like a horrible thing, but it's still heavy metal, so that's pretty fucking.
Dude, what do you mean,
dude?
That is fucking sick, but yeah.
You're gonna pick up some fucking ladies tonight with that one.
Yeah.
At least all I did was kill a baby seal with my bare hands.
Fuck, all I did was fuck my mom.
Fuck, dude, the whole band fucked your mom. That wasn't even for heavy metal. It was just for fun. That was actually how we ended up winding up doing the fucking thing that we ended up doing when we wound up fucking writing Bang Bang at the old folks home.
I remember that, yeah. Great.
It's true.
It's true. Oh, Y'all having a good time so far? Hey man, you having a good time? You having a good time? You should tell your face, bro. Just go have your brain go, hey face, let's look like we're having a good time. You should look like you're bummed out, dude. Let me tell you something, man. If you walk around like that, you might as well go to a Soundgarden concert here. You know what I'm saying? Steel Panther's about having a good fucking time escaping reality, man. No matter what your problems are, you leave me high when you walk through the door, and you get drunk and you have fun. Hey, you know, yeah.
You're a fucking mom. You know what, dude? I gotta tell you, what you don't realize is there's a lot of dudes here that brought their girlfriends are probably staring at the lead guitar player going, dude, how can I suck that fucking dude's dick tonight?
You know, especially that girl in the wheelchair. She's like,
trust me. It's gonna be easy to fuck, she can't run away, you know? It's gonna look like, there's a lot of fucking girls, you know, a lot of dudes, a lot of chicks and shit. You know, fucking, a lot of dudes are a little bit jealous of how fucking good our lead singer looks. Well, at least I'm jealous of how good I look in spandex. And I gotta say, you know, it's fucking, there's a lot of fear there. And, you know, some guys are afraid that the girls are gonna get on this fucking stage and show their fucking tits, and that can very, very well happen a lot in the next couple songs. But the bottom line is this, you don't have to be afraid of your girlfriend showing her fucking tits, dude. It's not that big of a deal to let your girlfriend show her tits.
Dude, it's fucking natural. God gave boobs from Tennessee, dude.
Trust me, your girlfriend showing her tits on stage at the Steel Panther show is not gonna seem like a big deal when you fucking go on YouTube tomorrow and you see us all giving her a golden child backstage. So it's all relative, you know what I'm saying, dude?
Yeah, dude, but it is all relative, man. You have to remember this, dude. You have to act like this is the last fucking night you're ever gonna be alive and fucking make it worth your life, dude.
If you're a fucking girl, you should suck everybody's dick in the room right now.
Yes. And this next song we're about to do is gonna require some crowd participation, okay?
Everybody who's not sucking dicks needs to sing along.
It's very simple. When I put the mic out to you guys, I want to hear you say, yeah! Hold on. You ready?
Yeah! Good job, Michael!
That was pretty good. Let's try it again.
Yeah! Good job, Michael!
I think they're ready to party like tomorrow's the end of the world.
Yeah! Come on!
fucking did a great job on that song. But again, make some noise for yourselves. That was awesome. I put the mic out and you went,
yeah! Oh my God, you're such a good lead singer, man.
I know.
You guys have no idea. When I was putting this band together, it was like, there was a lot of good lead singers in LA, but a lot of them were fucking busy, like Mark Slaughter, fucking.
The singer from Yellow Card, he was busy.
John Carlo, he wasn't born yet, so it was very difficult. But when I finally found this fucking guy, it was like, okay, if he loses like fucking 20 pounds, he's gonna be killer. But it didn't happen.
You know what? I didn't like that. When I first met him, he goes, man, you look like a chubby demon rub.
But you know what, dude, over the years, I've grown to look at you more like a fucking. Like a fucking meatloaf with long hair, you know what I'm saying?
Well, I like to refer to myself as skinny version of Vince Neil, so fuck you.
Which is cool, because you can still be about 40 pounds overweight and be a skinny version of Vince Neil. I don't even think Vince Neil's ever been a skinny version of Vince Neil.
You know what? It's the holiday season.
It's the holiday season.
Which means you
just I just wrote that right fucking there. I'm moving to fucking Nashville!
Let me see if you can write something after this.
Hey, Satchel, write a jingle. I'm writing a jingle now, and you're gonna hold me all night long while the sun can not clear. Oh my God, I'm going to fucking Nashville!
That's amazing.
And I can be country too. I'm moving to Nashville.
You sound like you're a Creed.
Shut up, dude. Don't ever say the word Creed on this fucking stage.
Well, you're starting to sound like Scott Sapp, like you're fucking crazy and I'm cracked.
Listen, dude, I can't help it if you're broken into my fucking bank account. Fucking, they fucking got my fingerprints somehow. I don't want to talk about it right now. What I want to talk about. How many people love the Christmas season? Raise your hand unless you're a fucking terrorist. That's a fun way to sort out the terrorists.
Hey, it's a good season to be kissing the girls under the camel toes, you know what I mean?
I got good news.
What?
We're serving fucking eggnog fresh from the nozzle backstage. Lucky for you.
That's sperm from the penis.
Jesus, that's what they're telling me.
Everybody makes noise for Stick Zanini on the bells.
These are not just any bells, dude. Those are fucking. Can of sleigh bells, fucking
Polar Express.
Exactly. The only people in here are the ones who believe, dude.
Do you believe?
Do you believe in Nashville? Do you believe in Santa Claus? Put your fucking hands up and say, I do, Microsoft. I'll tell you what, you're gonna believe in Santa Claus, because he got a brand new fucking Christmas song, and it just fucking dropped on YouTube.
What did it drop?
Shit.
That is such fucking lame.
I wanted to say Billboard, but it fucking actually went to number 492 with a bullet. Woo! That's pretty good for us. The song is called The Stocking Song, and if you haven't heard it, check it out. It's gonna fucking blow your fucking tits off and have to pick it back up before.
And do me a favor, it's only 2 minutes long, so if you have an iPhone, it's time to record it in
HD. Slow motion. One, two.
So when you say about candy canes, all the ladies do. Candy canes were meant for sucking, so don't you think about trying to chew? How about a little eggnog? I got my homemade recipe. You're gonna get a long drunk on my eggnog, even though it's alcohol free. Yeah. I'm gonna stuff your stocking this year. Gonna fill it up. It's gonna feel so good when I slide my gifts into it tonight. I'm gonna stuff your stocking this year. Gonna fill it up with all I got. Knickknacks and candies gonna hit your stocking G-spot. I know you like your toys, girl. Toys to fulfill your needs. You gotta only use double-A batteries and run at variable speeds. Gonna stuff it with an iPhone. All I ask is some tit for tats. If you can memorize a Kama Sutra, man, I think they make an app. Gonna help.
You know what I'm talking about.
I'm talking about balls.
Totally. Chocolate balls.
Oh, make it weird for the one black guy here. Thanks for that.
I wanna thank you for the loving that you spread over me. I've been singing about you on a mixed CD. And you won't have to wonder if you copy me. You'll be screaming my name when you sit down to pee.
You guys fucking kicked ass by side one! I mean, I'm not saying there was a contest or anything, but if there was a contest, we fucking won the contest!
Fuck that.
That was awesome.
I want to do that contest. I want to do a contest.
Dude, listen, there is no contest. It was not a competition. I'm just saying that you guys would have lost had there been one. That's all.
I think we should have a competition.
It doesn't matter. It really doesn't matter.
I think we should have a competition. What do you guys think?
You guys! It is not important who wins or loses, okay?
What?
We just happen to win!
Fuck that. Are you guys ready? Let's do this shit. Give me some guitar.
What are we
say
doing?
Yeah!
I'm hopped up on Seattle City.
I said, fuck yeah, that was fun. Listen, dude.
What, dude?
I think it's time right fucking now to unleash something that makes us particularly fucking special right here in fucking Nashville, where everybody's focused on being a good musician and useless shit like that. Okay, this band is focused on what really fucking matters. How good we look. And what you're about to fucking see cannot be cannot. Nobody else is gonna do this. No matter how far you fucking look, I don't care where you fucking go, to what fucking country, or what fucking planet in the fucking galaxy, is this guy, is the guy that fucking does it best. Ladies and gentlemen, sir, please put your Facebook down for just a minute. The guy who was voted the foxiest fucking guy on the Sunset Strip. Not one, but two motherfucking weeks in a row, dude. Back in 1987. He was only 35 years old. Put your fucking hands together for Mr. Lexi Pops on the head. Fucking hey, how many people see that video on YouTube, Bebo?
I'll tell you how many, over 2,500 at this point.
Oh yeah, fuck yeah.
Well, yeah, it's going pretty fucking well.
Well, I'll tell you what, it's time for us to celebrate the song that broke Steel Panther to the fucking worldwide success we're enjoying right now.
Michael, hold on there, soldier.
What's that there, Chief?
Hold on there, fucking rock soldier.
What do you want there, Chief?
Listen, this is a fucking great crowd. I'm gonna say it right fucking now. I don't think it's fucking overstating it. This is the fucking best fucking crowd we have played to all fucking week long!
Some of the hottest girls in the audience too, like right there.
Oh yeah, dude.
You know what, dude? We should get her on stage and have her show her tits.
What's the problem from you? Come on, come. There's so many hot girls, dude. Let me tell you something. John Karabi from Motley Crue would have this fucking stage packed with fucking pussy, dude. It would have been like a fucking...
Well, John Karabi's not fucking here right now.
Well, let me tell you something. Mark Slaughter would have this stage packed with vagina. It would have been like a fucking kingdom of vagina up here. And Mark Slaughter would have been the fucking prince of pussy.
He would have been the king of cock. Fuck you. Anyways, hey, you're really cute. What's your name? It doesn't matter. But... I mean, really. Hey, you know what, though? Seriously, I gotta tell you, I've seen a lot of girls because I've been around the world, you know, and fuck, you got some great tits, man. You're welcome.
You're a show, dude.
I hope you guys want to see this girl's moves right now.
Let's see if you fucking...
Wait. Back up a little bit.
Let's see if you're the prince of pussy or the fucking duke.
Right here, on the X. There you
Let's
go.
See if you're the fucking king of fucking pussy or the fucking duke of douchebag right fucking now.
Yeah! Fuck yes. Where are you going? Hey!
Wow, she showed her tits and you're still not gonna fuck her. I am disappointed in you, Michael.
Dude, let me tell you something.
Girl,
hey,
Satchel,
what a girl.
I don't even want to see our singer fuck this girl on stage.
When a girl shows her tits on stage, she gets a backstage pass.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Yeah, it comes with some free thing of cocaine right on the back of the
Listen, that's just the first pass. A lot of people don't know how this works. They get the green pass if they show their tits.
Come on.
Then they get into the fucking purgatory area, and if they pass the fucking test for syphilis and chlamydia, they get the fucking red pass. And
what's the red pass?
They get them back to see the crew, and then after they fuck the crew, they get the blue pass. If they take it in the fucking ass, they get the blue pass. That's when they come to see me. And then I got the fucking video camera all the fucking summer.
Hey, you better watch out with this chick. She'll suck your dick and then punch you in the face. Woo! Alright. Let's see some jail titties.
Oh my god. Michael.
Oh my god, here we go.
I'm free. Whoa! Wow. That is so fucking sexy. And you know what's really cool about the girl?
What?
I'm pretty sure every one of us could fit our fucking dicks into one of her earrings.
If you're a girl and you want to get on stage, you got to raise your hand, because I can't tell you. Come on up, don't be afraid.
Or if you're a guy, you've already had the surgery done. This is so fucking exciting, Michael. You know what we really should do? If you want to get some serious fucking pussy on this fucking stage, we should fucking play our fucking bestest song ever called Death to All But Fucking Metal.
Man. Yes.
Make it suck until the rhythm just begins.
Hey, we really, first of all, Mr. Light Guy, can you please light the audience up and light up the stage a little more? Let's make it a party. Here we go. What's up, guys? I want to wish from everybody here in the band, I want to thank every one of you for spending your hard-earned money during the holiday season to buy a ticket to see us. We so appreciate it. I'm serious, man. All right. How many people got to get up and go to work tomorrow, too? We appreciate it, staying up late, maybe getting a babysitter, whatever the fuck you got to do, spend that money on cocaine when it's on a weekend night. I get it. Why don't we do something cool? Why don't we sing along together, everybody? This is a song that every one of you know, and I want to hear you sing it with me. You guys fucking ready?
I will give you the stars in the sky, but they're too far away. If you were a hooker, you know I'd be happy to stay. If you were a guy, I'd be suddenly gay. Cause my heart belongs.
Hey, please make some noise. What the fuck are you doing, dude? How many guys want to see Satchel make out with his mom? Everybody make some noise for Satchel on guitar.
Thank you.
Hey, mom.
Don't you fuck my mom, Michael.
Don't
you do it.
I won't. I don't want crabs again. On the drums, make some noise for Snix Zetinia. And on the bass guitar, make some noise for Lexi Fox. Thank you sincerely for making our dream come true tonight. Right here, right fucking now. We're still mad and we'll see you fucking very soon. Yeah.